Okay, in the previous class, I was explaining this problem. You see this problem. In this problem, they asked to prepare branch account. Okay, only branch account they asked. If there is a necessity, you have to prepare the debtors account or PT cash account. Remember this. Okay. Regarding this, opening stock comes on the debtors debit side. Debtors debit side, goods sent to branch debit side. Gross sale is given. Cash sale goes to branch account, credit side as by cash or bank. And gross sale is given here. Out of this gross sale, you deduct the cash sale. You deduct the cash sale. That means 84,500 is the gross sale. Gross sale means total sale. Total sale is 84,500. Out of that, you deduct 38,400. 38,400 you deduct. Then whatever remains, that is called as credit sale. Credit sale. Okay, so take the total sale, deduct the cash sale, remaining is credit sale. Credit sale comes in the debtors account debit side. This is the point you remember. Okay, credit sale is not given in the problem. You have to calculate credit sale. You have to calculate credit sale. Remember this. Okay. You calculate credit sale. After this, branch expense paid by head office means it is the cash paid by head office to branch for expense. Branch account debit side. Bad debt goes to debtor's account. Furniture purchased by branch. Furniture is purchased by branch with the permission of head office. 1,000 rupee. Okay. This 1,000 worth furniture purchased by branch is to be considered as asset of branch. Asset of branch, and it comes in the closing balance. You have to take this amount in the closing balance. And while giving cash to head office, you have to give 1,000 less. Remember this. 1,000 less because 1,000 rupee furniture purchased. Whatever branch collects the cash, out of total collection, 1,000 is to be deducted and remaining amount paid to head office. Remember this. Okay, I'll show that amount in the account. Then return to head office. Branch account credit side, stock, closing, branch account credit side, debtors, branch account credit side. Okay. In this problem, cash collection is not given. Collection of cash is not given. Therefore, you have to prepare branch debtors account. Collection is not given. Therefore, you have to prepare branch debtors account. Okay. Now you see the solution. This is the branch account. In the branch account debit side, two balance brought down, stock, debtors, total 33,500. Second item, goods sent to branch, 86,000. Third item, to bank account, expense 1,000 paid by head office. Okay. The items completed. Come to the credit side. By bank. By bank means it is the cash paid to head office by branch. It is the cash paid by the branch to head office. Means branch collect the cash from debtors and by sale of goods on cash. the total amount is given to head office. Okay, while giving cash to head office, 1000 is to be deducted here. 1000 you have to deduct because 1000 worth furniture purchased. Remember this. Sariya name before. Yavudu buy bank andre enada branch avaru head office rokka kudtar. Branch avaru head office rokka tumtar. Heng andakidra divasa yet jama aagtittar. Yavrlin jama aagtati udri odaru yet kottittaru. ರೋಕ್ ಮಾರಿದ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಎಟ್ ಬಂದಿರ್ತದೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಜಮಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರ. ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಜಮಾ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರ ಅದ್ರ 1000 ಕಳೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಆಗತ್ತೇನೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರ 1000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದರು. ಯು ಸಿ ಯರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಇಸ್ 34,8400. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಲೀವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐಟಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೂಡ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್. Return is there. Closing balance, stock, closing debtors like this. And here you have to write the furniture. Furniture 1000 rupee. Furniture purchased by branch is there. That furniture remains with branch. Therefore, you have to take that furniture in the closing balance. This is purchased during the year. Okay. Then I'll draw the branch debtors account. In the branch debtors account, two balance brought down, two credit sale. Under the credit sale, you have to take 84,500. 84,500 is the gross sale. That is total sale. Out of total sale, you deduct cash sale. You deduct cash sale 38,400. Okay, 38,400. Then whatever remains, that is the credit sale. Clear? Then you write bad debt. Bad debt is there 500. Closing balance of debtors is 19,000. Okay. Problem completed. Problem completed. You take the total 61,600. Okay. Then whatever difference comes, that difference is called as cash or bank. 42,100. 42,100 rupee collected from debtors. 38,400 is the cash sale. So these two items is the total cash. 80,500. Out of 80,500, 1,000 rupee furniture purchase. 1,000 is paid for purchase of furniture. Therefore, you deduct it. Sariya nodkori. Andra rok marid 38,400. Collection 42,100. Total cash is 80,500. Okay. ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 80,500 80,500 ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ 80,500 ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರ ಕಡೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ 1000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ. 1000 ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ 1000 ಕಳೀರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಲೆಸ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ 1000, ಲೆಸ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ 1000. ನಾವ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್. ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ 79,500. 79,500 ಇಸ್ ಪೇಡ್ ಟು head office. Okay, then 1000 furniture is the closing balance. This is the point you remember. And take the total. Total is 1,23,000. Then difference is 2500. This 2500 is called as profit. Profit or general P&L account. Okay, then come to the next problem. You see the next problem. From the following particulars relating to Bidar branch for the year ending 31/12/2009, show branch account in the books of head office. They asked to prepare branch account in the books of head office. Okay, one by one, tell me. Stock on 1/1/2009, debit or credit? Branch account.
Debit side.
Branch account debit side. Okay, next debtors 1/1/2009
branch account debit side.
Branch account debit side. Then debtors account debit side. Okay. Next, PT cash.
Branch account debit side.
Okay, goods sent to branch during the year.
Branch account debit.
Goods sent to branch during the year. Debit or credit?
Debit.
Debit. Goods returned by goods returned to head office.
Credit side of branch account.
Credit side. And sales at branch is given. Sales at branch. Sales at branch. Cash sale.
Cash credit side of sale. Branch account.
Then credit sale.
Debtors account.
Debit side. Okay, you don't take this in the branch account. This will not come in the branch account. This comes in the debtors account. Clear? Then cash received from debtors.
Debtors account credit side.
Then
branch account. Credit side.
Sales return.
Debtors account credit side.
Debtors account credit side. Bad debt.
Debtors account credit side.
Discount allowed.
Debtors account credit side.
Branch expense paid by head office.
Branch account debit side.
Then PT cash sent to branch. PT cash sent to means sent to branch means given to branch.
Branch account debit side.
These two items are coming under same head. Branch expense paid by head office. PT cash expense paid by head office. First item is relating to expense. Second is for PT cash. Okay. These two items you take under the head to cash or to bank. One is expense. Second is PT cash. Then PT cash expense incurred by the branch. PT cash expense incurred by the branch. Where I have to take this item? Yes, anybody?
PT cash account credit side.
Very good. What is your name?
Zenith Sidnari.
Okay. Very good. PT cash account credit side. This item will not come in the branch account. So branch account, in the branch account, opening PT cash, cash received from the head office and closing PT cash. Three items only comes regarding PT cash and debtors. Okay, three items comes and PT cash expense will not come in the branch account. Then again, furniture purchased by branch is here. Furniture purchased by branch. This furniture purchased by branch is to be shown in the closing balance. You show this amount in the closing balance. And it is purchased by branch. Therefore, while giving cash to head office, you deduct this amount. Head office rokka kodumu nit kadim kodbekagutte. Nimkade rokka irudilla. This is the point you remember. Then closing stock. Closing stock on 31st 12 2009 is there. This amount is the branch account credit side closing stock, closing balance. Okay. You see in this problem, in the opening there are three. What are the three items? Stock, debtors, petty cash. Three items are there in the opening. In the opening balance there are three, but in the closing how many balances are there? In the closing there is only one, that is stock. Remaining two are not given in the problem. Remaining two are not given in the problem. Therefore you have to prepare two accounts. One is debtors account for closing debtors. Debtors account for closing debtors, petty cash account for petty cash expense, or you have to write the equation. Okay. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು? ಡೆಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಡೆಟರ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದ, ಪಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರ ಪಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದ. ಮತ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಕೊಟ್ಟರ ಅಂತಕೊಂಡು ಇಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬಿಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸರಿ, ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತು? ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಯು ಸಿ ದಿ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಇನ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ first item is two balance brought down. Stock is there, debtors is there, PT cash 1500 is there. Total is 3,16,500. This is the first item. Second item is goods sent to branch, 3,75,000 is there. And third item, two bank. Under the two bank, two items given separately. Two items given separately. Cash given to branch for expense and cash given for branch for PT cash. For PT cash is there and for expense is there. Therefore, you have to take two items in the inner column. Two items in the inner column and take the total to outer column. Expense 22,500, for PT cash 3,750. Okay, these two items are given separately and you take carefully. And total of this is 26,250. Okay, three items completed, debit side. Come to the credit side. First is cash sale. Cash sale 2,25,000 is there. 2,25,000 cash sale is there. Then next is collection from debtors is there. Collection from debtors is 2,62,500. This is the total cash collected, 4,87,500. 4,87,500 is the amount collected by the branch. It is amount collected by the branch by way of cash sale and collection from debtors. Andra branch avaru ishtu duddanna gole madidaru yav riti cash sale mattu debtors kadinda aar ishtu dudd head office kodak avar kade irudilla yakanta kedra. ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ? ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೇಲ್ 2,25,000 ಐತದ. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೋಕ್ ಮಾರಿದ ದುಡ್ಡು. ಆ ನಂತರ ಡೆಟರ್ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಇಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದು 2,62,000 ಐತಿ. ಎರಡು ಕೂಡಿಸಿ 4,87,500 ಆಗ್ತದೆ ದುಡ್ಡು. ಇಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡು ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಅವ್ರ ಕಡೆ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್. This amount is not available for remitting to head office. The reason is they spent 7,500 for purchase of furniture. Furniture khareedi madidre 7,500 rupay kottu adakka 7,500 rupay kadim maadi ulada dudda head office kodbek. So less furniture purchase 7,500. Then remaining amount is 4,80,000. 4,80,000 is paid to head office. This is the point you remember. Okay. Then next item is goods sent to branch, that is return 4,500. Next is balance carried down. Under that stock is there. debtors balance is not given in the problem. Opening balance is given in the problem. Closing balance is not given in the problem. I'll write here. By balance carried down, stock is 93,750 is there in the problem. Debtors is not given. PT cash is also not given. These two balances are not given, but these two balances are there in the opening balance. Sariyagi nodri. ಯಾವುದು ಈ ಎರಡ್ ಐಟಮ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹಂಗ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯಾರ ಯಾರೇ ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದಾವು 1, 2, 3 ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಇವು ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಮೂರು ಇರಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ತಪ್ಪತ್ತೆ ಸರಿ ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಟುಕೋ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರೆಯಬೇಕು If there are three items in the opening balance, there must be three items in the closing balance. Debtors balance is not given for you people. PT cash is not given to you people. Okay, you remember this point. And next, one more item comes here that is called as furniture 7,500. Fourth item, it is purchased by branch. Furniture on stock it. Closing balance ಆಗಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಖರೀದಿ ಮಾಡಿದಾರೆ ಅವರು ಓಕೆ ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಯರ್ ಫರ್ನಿಚರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಯರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಡೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಐ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಡೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಪಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ Okay, you see the equation for PT cash. PT cash closing balance is equal to opening PT cash opening balance. PT cash opening balance plus cash PT cash received. PT cash received minus PT cash expense. This is the equation you write. And tell me the what is the opening PT cash balance. What is the opening PT cash balance? 1,500. Then what is the cash received from head office for PT cash? Cash received from head office for PT cash.
3,750.
Plus 3,750. Then what is the PT cash expense in the problem?
22,500.
PT cash expense given in the problem. This is for expense. 22,500 is expense purpose amount given. I explained in the problem last item. This is not the item. Remember this. It is expense for other purpose. In your problem, there is amount 3,000. PT cash expense during the year. PT cash expense during the year is 3,000 in your problem. Okay. You have to take 3,000, not 22,500. Then ultimate answer is equal to 2,250. 1,500 plus 3,750 minus 3,000 is equal to 2,250 is the closing balance. I'll write that closing balance here. Okay. I recorded the closing balance here. PT cash. For debtors, I'll prepare the debtors account. I have to prepare the debtors account. In the debtors account, opening balance you have to write. Then credit sale you write. It is given me problem credit sale. The next is buy sales return. Then by bank, cash collected from debtors. Cash collected from debtors. Then bad debt is there. Thereafter, discount is there. Then you take the total and ascertain the balance. Total is 4,05,000. Balance is 1,37,625. This is the closing balance. You take this balance in the previous slide. In the branch account. This balance you take in the branch account. In the debtors closing balance is 1,37,625 from debtors account. It is from debtors account. Okay. Like this, now here are the four balances. In the opening, there are three items, closing four, because you purchased furniture. Okay. You take the total to the outer column. Outer column total is 2,41,125. 2,41,125 is the total. And you take the outer column total, this is 7,25,625 total. Then difference is called as general P&L account. 7,875 is the profit. 7,875 is the profit. Remember this. Okay. If you draw the PT cash account, I'll show the PT cash account. Equation already shown. If you draw PT cash account, in the PT cash account, you take opening balance. Opening balance 1,500. 1,500 is opening balance. And cash received from head office is, cash received from head office for expenses 3,750. Okay. In the credit side, you take by PT cash expense. PT cash expense is 3,000. PT cash expense 3,000. Now you close the account. If you close the account, total is 5,250. Difference is 2,250. Okay. So this difference is called as closing balance. This is called as closing balance. In this way, you prepare the account and assert in the balance. Otherwise, you write the equation and assert in the balance. Okay. And this is the second problem based on furniture. This is enough for today. These are the problems based on cost price method. Okay, cost price method. And in the next period, I'll take the problems based on the cost price method, same on the second method. Second method means final account method. Final account method. Final account method means you have to prepare trading account and profit and loss account. Instead of preparing branch account, you have to prepare the branch trading account, branch P&L account. Okay. This first method I completed, and in the second method, final accounts, I will take the cost price method problems. Okay. I'll complete all the cost price problems based on first method and second method. Then in the second method, you tell me what are the items coming on the debit side of trading account. What are the items coming on the debit side of your trading account? You studied the single entry system of bookkeeping. Okay. What is the first item in the trading account?
Opening stock.
Two opening stock. Okay. What is the second item?
To purchase.
What are the adjustments to purchase?
Cash purchase and credit purchase.
Two purchase. Under that two purchase, what are the items? Cash purchase and
credit purchase.
Then what is the adjustment? One more adjustment.
Purchase return.
Okay. Instead of that item, you have to take goods sent to branch and less returned by branch. This is the change in this method. Instead of purchase, what to take? Instead of purchase, you take to goods sent to branch by head office. Okay. In that goods sent to branch by head office, less returned by branch. Less returned by branch. Clear? Or any doubt? Then next item is after purchase, next item is wages, carriage inward, octroi, gas, electricity, and so on. Then what is the first item on the credit side?
Sales.
Buy sales. Under these sales, what are the items you write?
Cash sales, credit sales, and less sales return.
And you remember one important point here. You take cash sale. Secondly, you take credit sale. Less return by customer. Less return by customer. Remember this point very carefully. Return by customer comes on credit side. Okay. Return by branch comes on debit side. Remember this. Return by branch comes on debit side. You remember, returned by branch is just like purchase return. Return by branch is called as purchase return. And returned by customer is called as sale return. These two points you remember carefully. Okay. Then whatever items you take, next item is closing stock. Okay. You write the closing stock. Any doubt? Easter changes maari nim trading account nim gotaddi purchase badli yen bariri what to write instead of purchase what to write am I audible or not my voice is clear or not
sent to
instead of purchase you write goods sent to branch less returned by branch any doubt yen barire goods sent to branch barire less returned by branch barire yav ritti purchase return barittidre purchase return badli yav tagore goods sent to branch tagore returned by branch kelire ad mugid ad one changes alli mod credit side antu eradu same idav cash sale credit sale bartatti sales return nu kelithire adaka customer antu kartivi Return by customer and the karitiv. Sales return al karitiv. Ist mugit. Inna P&L account na yav togobek anta kedra PT cash expense togobek nu. Sari ayana nenpirko. Yav togobeku? PT cash expense nu togobek. Clear? PT cash expense you have to take. Then in this method you have to prepare debtors account and also PT cash account. Alli more item bekiddo. Illu debtors account hakbekagutta. In this method also you have to prepare debtors account. Why debtors?